The overall Fraser Valley real estate market is facing price declines in nearly every area and asset class. As the market peaked in July with the board area reporting the benchmark price of $1,046,700. And the most recent stats show a decline down to just $1,015,000. But one asset class in one area is bucking the trend. And in fact, even in the face of interest rates three times higher than pandemic levels, townhomes in Langley are still increasing in value against all odds. How is that even possible? Well, we're going to explore the market that is defying all logic in today's episode of Holy Shit, have you seen Langley townhouse prices this month? And of course, if you would like to stay up to date on my market of Surrey, Langley, or anywhere in the Fraser Valley, please subscribe to the channel and click the notification bell so you don't miss my next update. And of course, if you own a Langley townhome and you are just watching this video to feel really good about your investment, go ahead and click the like button for the YouTube algorithm because you made a great buy. And if you're looking to buy a townhouse in Langley or you want to take advantage of the still crazy high prices, you can book a call with me right now using the link in the description below at a time that works best for you. And before I hop into the numbers, let's talk about a couple of factors that seem to be driving this Langley townhouse market. First off, and yes, make sure to leave your jokes in the comments, but Langley is doing so well because, well, it's not Surrey. Let's face it, Surrey always gets the bad rap in the Lower Mainland. Even if it is set to become the largest city by population in British Columbia within the next decade. But if you're coming from Vancouver, Burnaby, Alberta, or anywhere else, you have been told to avoid Surrey. So even though Langley, in fact, does have a higher violent crime rate than the city of Surrey, your father-in-law still thinks it's a nicer place to live. So you skip the first three exits on Highway 1 after the bridge, and you turn off into Langley, the city that is actually two cities. And it's not only where the Vancouver Giants now play, but it's also where property taxes are higher and the municipalities of both Langley City and the township of Langley will hunt you down if you install a secondary suite without permits. Unlike Surrey, where the city basically doesn't care. Second, most of Langley outside of maybe Walnut Grove has traditionally been made up of single-family detached homes and acreages. And since both Langleys have made massive shifts towards density to help with the housing crisis, most of the townhomes located in Yorkson, Willoughby, and Murrayville are much newer. And you should, I guess, expect that newer homes will sell for more per square foot than older ones. Because, you know, they're new and fancy. These areas, as I said, used to be large lots with just a single home on them, and now they're being turned into affordable townhomes, if you can call anything affordable these days. But a trend also in Langley townhomes is that, well, they seem to be getting both larger and more luxurious as they are built. For example, there are more townhomes and specifically new townhomes in Langley that feature primary bedrooms on the main floor than any other city that I could think of right now. Sure, you can find primary on the main in Abbey and White Rock. Sorry, I mean South Surrey. But those are now older and smaller units. And who really wants to live in that 1996 built 2200 square foot North White Rock townhouse if you could buy a 3000 square foot newer unit at basically the same price, giving you virtually an entire extra floor by the way of an underground basement? But enough of me pumping the benefits of luxurious Langley townhomes. Let's dive into the numbers so you can see exactly what I mean. Okay, so here we go. Let's first start off by looking at the Fraser Valley as a whole and then comparing Langley to Surrey and Abbotsford, the cities that surround it. Now, these are townhome pricing. As you can see, the overall Fraser Valley market is the blue line. And we did see a peak right around July, where almost everything else peaked as well. And now we're seeing a slight downturn in the marketplace. The red line, this is now going from west to east. The red line is Surrey, which is in probably the sharpest decline of them all. And then Abbotsford being much further out in the valley. It did peak a little bit later. Let's see if we can determine exactly where. It did actually peak all the way into September by like $1,000, not really a big deal. And now we're seeing the downturn as well. But look at that green line of Langley, which from, let's call it March of this year, has been on a steady climb. And when most places in the Lower Mainland, and particularly townhomes, peaked in July, Langley has gone from $848,000 benchmark pricing, now up another $20,000 or more. And if you want to look at it on a number of sales basis, look at the number of sales over the overall Fraser Valley market, just absolutely tanking this blue line here. The city of Surrey as a whole doing the exact same thing, going from 281 townhome sales in June down to this last month in the statistics of 141. But Langley, sure, it's dipping down, but it's not dipping down a whole lot from the peak of the June market at 108 sales to now 59. And that number is actually up 11.3% since last year. But I don't want to stop there and just look at Langley as one because, well, Langley is a big, big place. For instance, let's start off here again with the blue line. The blue line is the overall area of Langley, which includes both city of Langley and the township that goes all the way out to Abbotsford. And you're going to see that that steady increase has been happening as it has in all of the other areas as well. But when you break it down a little bit further, Langley City is the red line. Langley City is, let's face it, not the nicest area in Langley to live. Therefore, the prices are down lower. They also have a lot of much older homes in that area. But look at just the last couple of months, the big shoot up in values there from $756 almost up to $800,000. Walnut Grove should be no surprise. Walnut Grove is the green. That's the area north of Highway 1, if you don't know the Langley area. Older townhomes, but very desirable schools and communities there. Very, very desirable area to be. But look at Murrayville. Murrayville is absolutely crushing it right now. And you look at the peak in Murrayville, crested exactly $1 million. It seemed to have bottomed this last year, falling back upwards of 15% to 843 and is now back up to 924 and increasing. Now, the craziest part of this whole thing is that normally when we look at what is the best investment, traditionally in real estate, honestly, it doesn't really matter. Often if you buy a condo here for however much, and then you buy a townhouse somewhere else for X amount more, well, the value of that most often just floats with the overall market, up 10%, down 10%, and of course, adjusted for the actual price of the asset. Because as the saying goes, a rising tide floats all boats. But that doesn't seem to really be applying to Langley townhomes, because much of the market is seeing the tide going out right now, meaning prices are dropping. And well, Langley townhome prices are going in the other direction. So let me know what you think in the comments down below. And remember that if you are interested in a Langley townhome and you need help, you can book a call with me by using the link in the description below. While you're down there, you can also download my Inform Buyer's Guide. Please remember to subscribe, click the like button, and we'll see you in a couple of days.